Why is interior monologue the most important part of your story? Maurice here from NobleCopy.com, and today we're going to be talking about interior monologue and why is it so important to your novel? Well, it's important because it allows your readers to connect with your characters, and more importantly, it allows your characters to freely express themselves to your readers. Just think of it that way. Literature needs inner monologue. Without it, you just have plot and physical action. And to me, that is not enough. If I want to watch something, if I want to experience a piece of art that is just physical action and plot, I'll watch a movie. Literature is the only medium that allows insight into a character the way interior monologue allows. Okay, in film, you know, there's very rarely a voiceover or something like that that allows you to know what the characters are thinking. And literature basically feeds off of the interior monologue. Also, the way interior monologue is written really can highlight the skill of the author. And what I mean is that a lot of beginning writers seem to skimp on the interior monologue parts. This happens all the time. For whatever reason, they are more focused on plot and subplot and physical action. They stay away from writing what their characters are thinking. They stay away like the plague, basically. I don't know why. I think they're afraid to express their characters' thoughts for some reason. They would much rather write about physical action, like turning a doorknob, walking through the door, walking down the steps, preparing meals, plot, you know, plot A to B to C. They do whatever they have to do to get away from diving into the character's mind. And they seem to be obsessed with it. And that's how you know a beginning writer right there, is how well they write their character's interior thoughts. In my opinion, overall, interior monologue is not used enough. The way that I write interior monologue, and I also highly suggest this for you as well, is to always write more in a monologue than you need to, because it's easier to go back later and delete what you think is just fluff. Okay, it's easier to delete later on than it is to add later on. And the reason is because if you try to add later on, you know, a month, 2 months, 3 months down the road, you know, it's going to be extremely difficult to get back in your character's mind, you know, where you were, what you were thinking at that precise moment. You know, it's tough to get into that perspective all over again. And my suggestion to you is to just go on rants with interior monologue, go write a whole page, 2 pages if needed, and then go back and delete it. On a side note, interior monologue is not the same thing as stream of consciousness. They are kind of the same, but not really. If you're looking to learn more about stream of consciousness, I will leave a link below to my blog post. And the real choice that you're gonna have to make is how are you going to write it? And what I mean by that is, how is the interior monologue going to appear on the page? Okay, that is key. That is key because it affects how we, the readers, experience the interior monologue. Okay, and what I mean is you have 2 choices really. You can use italics and you can use dialogue tags. In this case, they would be called interior monologue tags, really. Okay, me personally, I don't like any interior monologue tags whatsoever. I don't like them in italics either. I just like one smooth narrative flow. It's easier to read that way. I find that when it is normal font and then it suddenly changes to italics, that kind of takes me out of the fictional dream. I would prefer if it was just all one thing, but that's just me. I don't know, if you want to write them with italics and with interior monologue tags, then cool, good for you. Go for it. I'm just saying that I prefer not to. Also, quotations. Never use quotations for interior monologue. That's just bad grammar right there. You do not want to do that. Also, I think that when you do use interior monologue, I think that you should use it frequently. And by frequently, I mean at least once per chapter, right? You don't have to, you know, overdo it in every single chapter, but it should be there to some considerable extent in each chapter. Whether that is your protagonist or your side character or your villain or whatever character that you decide to write about in that particular chapter, I definitely think that you should give some type of interior monologue for a good few paragraphs. Okay, so what types of interior monologue are there? Okay, well, there is direct interior monologue. So for example, right? So Bob walked into the Lamborghini dealership and checked out the cars. He knew he had no money to buy them. Wasting time was no problem for him. I like the black one better than the red one, he thought. Okay, so obviously the interior monologue is the I like the black one better than the red one, he thought. Okay, so in the interior monologue tag is he thought. So the way that I would write that is I like the black one better than the red one, period. Okay, no he thought, no italics. That is direct interior monologue. There's another one called indirect interior monologue. Okay, for example, Bob walked into the Lamborghini dealership and checked out the cars. He knew he had no money to buy them. Wasting time was no problem for him. He liked the black one better than the red one, he thought. So you see, there is a little bit of difference there. The pronouns are changed. He liked the black one better than the red one, he thought. Okay, so again, there is the interior monologue tag of he thought. I would just get rid of that. And instead of I, the pronoun is now he. Interior monologue can be just one word or one sentence. For example, Bob walked into the Lamborghini dealership and checked out the cars. No money to spend. Who cares? Not Bob. He liked the black one better. Steal it. Nah, no way. Jail. He walked right back out of the place. Before he hopped in his Camry, he took one last look at the Lambo and shook his head. Okay? Now, that is the type of interior monologue that is jumbled together. You can use one sentence or one word, like I said. That's perfectly fine. I rather enjoy that. I like that type of prose. To me, that really works. It keeps it exciting. I don't mind the long sentences and the short sentences and then just the one word. I like that. The bottom line is you don't want to overthink the interior monologue part. You don't want to make it too difficult for yourself. It's actually the most fun part of writing fiction. Okay, so do you agree with me or do you think I'm way off base? Let me know what you think in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe and like and check out my other videos as well. Have a good one.